tectonic lakes, those lakes which are originate, lakes which are originate due to, lakes which are originate due to folding and faulting processes, folding and folding, fold mountains, folding and folding means as a when the compressional forces are active on the surfaces of the earth crust due to the compression, different mountain hills they are originate. Due to the formation of the mountain hills in between the low-lying areas filled with the water. Low-lying areas filled with water. So tectonic lakes are formed through folding and faulting processes. Faulting processes means when two plates, they overlap each other, due to which the block mountains, they came into existence. Block mountains. Why they are occur? For example, this is as a strata. This is as the earth crust. Earth crust, due to the overlapping of a two plates, there are generally as a cracks are appeared. Or sometimes one plate, it lies in another one. So such cracks, these are visualized in such forms, in which some portion of the earth crust, it subsided downward and some portion, it rises up. Due to which the block mountains, they came into existence. So in between of two block mountains, the low-lying valley area, which is known as a graben, these are filled with the water. Is known as tectonic lakes. They are known as tectonic lakes. So as per the folding processes in India, there is a lake which has found in a tectonic movements is known as a Vullar lake in Jammu and Kashmir. Vullar in Jammu and Kashmir. W-U-L-A-R, Vullar lake in Jammu and Kashmir is an example of a tectonic lake which is formed through the folding processes. When the folds appears on a Himalayas, folds started to appear on Himalayas, under such circumstances, the low-lying areas, these were filled with water through a glaciated melted water. Such type of lakes are the tectonic lakes. Clear? Tectonic lakes. Still there any doubts?
Sir, Vullar Lake is an example of freshwater and tectonic both lakes.
Both. Vullar lines in a Jammu and Kashmir is an also example of a freshwater lake, but it has originated through the folding processes. It is the tectonic lake also. Yes, done, okay, everybody? Sir. Any doubts? Yes, Sanshya?
Sir, what is the low-lying area called?
Wait. Yes, Sanshya?
So what is the low-lying area called?
Low-lying area means depressions. When the stratas, when the earth crust, it has shaking due to the movement of a plates. Under such circumstances, some portion is subsided downward. Jo dab jata hai, downward chale jata hai. This is as a low-lying areas. Low-lying used because it is generally as the deeper than the mean sea level. Mean sea level remains same all over the world. All the oceans and the sea water bodies, they are having as a same level. Yes, Yug? Yes, Japji?
Japji. According to the new syllabus of revised Sir, according to the revised syllabus of CBSE, only maps will be there from this chapter.
From this chapter, drainage, there is a sum of the reduction. Such syllabus, it will be as applicable on the, it will be applicable on a term examinations, on a periodics, this chapter, it will be as assessed. Yes, Yug? Yug?
Sir, freshwater lakes example mein saata likh sakte hain?
Freshwater lake mein kiski?
Hello.
Haan ji.
सर फ्रेश वाटर लेक्स की एग्जांपल में सात ताल लिख सकते हैं
नो यस गुरुपाल
सर द सिलेबस गिवन बाय द सी इन द सी द ड्रेनेज चैप्टर इज इन द टर्म 2 ओनली इंडिया एंड साइज ऑफ लोकेशन एंड फिजिकल फीचर्स आर इज देयर इन टर्म 1
बट इट विल बी एज इट विल बी डिस्कस इन अ लेटर इफ यू आर हैविंग एनी क्वेश्चंस रिलेटेड विद अ चैप्टर देन आस्क क्लियर Tectonic leaks. Third are the saltwater leaks. Saltwater leaks. Any lake that has no natural drainage. Drainage outlet. Either as a surface stream means some of the lakes are there all over the world which are having as a source of a rivers like Mansarovar. Mansarovar is also example of a freshwater lake. So a large number of rivers are originates from a lakes. Either they are originates on a earth's surface or either underground surfaces. But the saltwater lakes are those lakes which has no natural drainage outlet. Either as a surface stream, or inside the earth crust. They become saline. Such lakes become saline because of high evaporation. When water accumulated on a surface for a longer duration, due to which salinity increases in soils. And when evaporation more occur than the remaining water, it will be having as a more salt content. Example, Sambhar Lake in Rajasthan, Sambhar, S-A-M-B-H-A-R, Sambhar in Rajasthan, So there is a one subcategory under the saltwater lakes, which are generally known as the lagoon. Yes, Japji, why we are discussing this as a lagoon? Because Chilika Lake in syllabus. So lagoon are the depressions lies on the coast of the country. Such depressions filled with saline water during high tides. Example, Chilika Lake in Odisha. When peninsular India it came into existence, there was as a depression existed on a eastern coast of the country, eastern coast of our country, during the time of high tides, when the water level increases, such increase in a Bay of Bengal, it filled that depression which lies on a eastern coast of a country, which now presently known as a Chilika Lake. It is now presently known as Chilika Lake. Clear? Yes. There, yes. What is your query?
Yes, sir. Good morning, sir.
Yes, good morning. हाँ जी बोलिए
सर. जो आपने टेक्टोनिक लेक्स का वुलर लेक बताया जम्मू एंड कश्मीर का, वो फ्रेश वाटर लेक्स की एग्जांपल
में भी फ्रेश वाटर में भी आएगा. वुलर इज आल्सो अ फ्रेश वाटर लेक, बट दिस इज द बेस्ट एग्जांपल ऑफ अ टेक्टोनिक लेक्स इन इंडिया. एनी अदर क्वेश्चन बच्चे?
नो सर, थैंक यू सर.
यस गुरुपाल. गुरुपाल आस्क क्वेरीज रिलेटेड विद द चैप्टर्स. गुरुपाल. Yes, Jia.
Sir, where is Chilika Lake present?
हाँ जी.
Sir, where is Chilika Lake present?
Chilika Lake in Odisha, on the coast of Odisha, where the Mahanadi makes the delta. Nearer to it is a Chilika Lake, Chilike. On a map of India, you can see on a coast of Odisha there is a hollow structure, small circle. Which has a marked on a course of a country. Yes, Pranay.
Okay, sir.
Pranay. Okay, let's continue the fourth type of lakes, artificial lakes. Artificial lakes are man-made lakes. Artificial lakes are man-made lakes. In order to enhance water for generation of Heidel Park, to provide water for irrigation.
Sir.
Yes. Yes, Pranay. To provide water for irrigation and.
Sir, वो by mistake हो गया था.
And. Water for irrigation, generation of Heidel Park, and to provide drinking water in urban areas. A number of lakes have been constructed. Example, Sukhna Lake for recreation, for tourism. Sukhna in Chandigarh for recreation. People generally has used the Sukhna not for as the source of a water, it just for their recreation enjoyment. Second, Govind Sagar, this is name of a reservoir which is built in a Bhakra Nangal Dam. So behind the walls of Bhakra Nangal Dam, where the water accumulated, that is known as the Govind Sagar. Govind Sagar. Another example is there, Govind Vallabh Pant Sagar. This lake built in a Rihand Sagar, R-I-H-A-N-D, Rehand Sagar Dam. Rehand Sagar Dam, which is built on a Son River. Son River, S-O-N-E, one of the tributaries of Ganga, peninsula originate tributary of Ganga, Son River, on which the Rehand Sagar Dam constructed. Rehand Sagar Dam constructed their reservoir that where the water accumulated for generation of electricity. Water collected for generation of electricity. That is known as a Gobind Ballabh Pant Sagar. That is known as the Gobind Ballabh Pant Sagar. Clear? These are the important lakes of our country. The important lakes of our country. Is that clear? The next topic asks the role of the rivers in economy. Role of rivers in economy. What is the role of the rivers in economy? First, as a development of civilization. Yes, there.
Yes, sir. Good morning. Oh, sir. Sir, आपने जैसे कहा कि in order to enhance water for generation of hydel power for irrigation and to provide drinking water in urban areas. तो सर उसके बाद आपने जब example बताया सुखना lake का तो वो आपने बताया कि वो
कल generation of hydel power, generation of hydel power, water for irrigation, for recreation, for fishing, water for drinking in urban areas, water for industries, etc. All these are the uses of a lakes at present. When the such purposes, they are accomplished through the artificial method of a lakes are known as the man-made or artificial lakes. They are known as the artificial lakes. Clear there? So role of the rivers. Rivers play a very important role in economy because the different activities of human which are related to the generation of their, the earning of their livelihoods are dependent on it. They are dependent on it. For example, the river water has generally used for the agricultural purposes, growth of economy, civilizations, etc. So rivers play a very significant role in growth of economy, in which the first has development of civilization, role of rivers in economy, development of civilization. Rivers have played the role in development of civilization. Most of the ancient civilization like Indus, Egyptian civilization, which developed on the banks of a Nile River, Chinese civilization developed on a Huang Ho River, they developed around the rivers. Rivers have been of fundamental importance throughout the human history. The banks of the rivers have witnessed great cultural and economic progress. Since ancient times, water, it was as the basic natural resource essential for the human agricultural and industrial activities. Clear? Second, agricultural activities, rivers and their associated alluvial soils provide the most productive agricultural lands of the country. The Ganga and Brahmaputra basin, which you read in a 7th standard, Ganga and Brahmaputra basin have been formed by the two great river systems. Agriculture is dependent on the monsoons for irrigation, and the rivers has been the backbone of the economy. Backbone means economies are based upon the rivers, because rivers, which are presently in India, one of the main sources of inland transport, inland waterways, these are generally occur due to rivers. Clear? Rivers play a very important role in economy. They are the backbone of the development of Indian agriculture. Clear? Indian agriculture. Now the third, human settlements. Human settlements. The valleys of rivers contain dense and concentrated settlements. So most number of the rivers on their banks, there are the large number of people are inhabiting. Most of the large cities are located on rivers. Not only do rivers provide in with essential water supplies, but they also receive the dilute and transport waste from settlements. So rivers are basically, at present, these are the natural carriages which are responsible for the solid and liquid waste from economy. Solid and liquid waste from cities. Because of this, the Ganga and Yamuna rivers, these are polluted, because Delhi, the wastewater of Delhi, it directly discharge in Yamuna River. Fourth, as industrial development has flourished along rivers, as many processes rely on water as a raw material, as a coolant, and the generation of hydroelectricity. There are a large number of industries are there which require regular supply of water. For example, iron and steel industries. For metallurgical industries like iron and steel industries, they require regular supply of water for cooling purposes. In the other side, in nuclear reactors, where the electricity generated in nuclear reactors, Gurupal, in nuclear reactors, where electricity is generally generated with the help of uranium, thorium, plutonium. In such nuclear reactors, water is significantly used for cooling purposes. Cotton textiles use the water in a larger quantities for washing and dyeing the clothes. Clear? Gurupal, pay attention. Next, as a means of transportation, means of transportation rivers are the important means of transportation at present important means of transportation at present because rivers are used for inland waterways they are used as the inland waterways rivers provide primary channels of inland transportation rivers provide primary channels of inland transportation not only directly in the form of navigable waterways not only directly in the form of navigable waterways but also indirectly through through their valleys where roads, railway lines and other routes are built. So India's longest inland waterway is on Ganga River, which move from Prayagraj, it is the newer name of Allahabad, Prayagraj to Hugli, Hugli, Prayagraj to Hugli, the India's longest inland waterway on Ganga River, which is used for a movement of goods and passengers towards Calcutta port. Due to the such infiltrations by the humans in a river channels, it led to the river pollution. Due to increase in industrialization, urbanization, river pollution is a serious threat to the rivers and aquatic life. The growing domestic, municipal, industrial, and agriculture demand for water. From rivers naturally affects the river water. As a result, more and more water is being drained out of the rivers, reducing their volume. A heavy load of untreated sewage discharge in river channels affects not only the quality of water but also the self-cleaning capacity of rivers. The increasing urbanization and industrialization is also responsible for increasing pollution level of many rivers. Clear? Pollution level in rivers. So this was our chapter as drainage. Any questions or queries? Yes, Tanvi.
Sir, please repeat the name of the longest inland water river.
It's on Ganga River. It's on Ganga River from Prayagraj, which is now the present name of Allahabad. Allahabad to Hooghly. Allahabad to Hooghly. So it is used for transportation of materials towards Calcutta Port. Towards Calcutta Port. This is the longest inland waterway on Ganga River from Allahabad, means Prayagraj, to Hooghly, H-U-G-L-I. Clear, Tanveen? Yes, Dhairya?
Yes, sir. सर मैं पूछ रहा था कि जैसे आपने जो यूजेस बताए थे आर्टिफिशियल लेक के उसमें आपने बोला था कि इट प्रोवाइड्स ड्रिंकिंग वाटर टू अर्बन एरियाज बट सर जब आपने एग्जांपल में सुखना लेक बताया था तो उसमें आपने कहा था कि वो एंटरटेनमेंट के लिए और वो लोग उसमें से पानी या वगैरह नहीं पीते
इट्स वाटर टूरिज्म फॉर रिक्रिएशन एंजॉयमेंट बोटिंग पर्पसेस के लिए उसको बनाया गया था उसका कोई और यूज नहीं है ठीक है जैसे गोविंद सागर डैम सॉरी गोविंद सागर लेक which built on a Bhakra Nangal dam. It's for the generation of electricity. Water accumulated in a Gobind Sagar, when the water level increases, it fall on a turbines of Bhakra Nangal for generation of electricity. So the use of a Sukhna lake, it's not for a generation of electricity, it's for a recreation purposes. Clear? So this much for today.